Welcome to a car collector's heaven. These rolling pieces of historic heavy metal are by no means standard, but consider their ages.
Un Ford 47.
A 47 Ford.
El mío es un Chevrolet 49.
49 Chevy.
Chevrolet 51.
And 51 Chevy.
Son vehículos muy viejos.
Andres Cruz Rodriguez says they're very old cars, but they still get it. They still run, and we're very proud of all of them. These classic cars that would be polished, pampered, and put in a garage in the U.S. put bread on the table in Cuba.
Para nosotros una necesidad, pues.
For us, it's a necessity, particularly for me, because I can't get another one.
Now, when a part on his 1951 Chevy breaks, Andres can't just go down to the store and pick up a new one. So he says, this is where el espíritu de la lucha comes in, the Cuban spirit of never giving up.
The U.S. embargo means no replacement parts, so ingenuity kicks in to keep things rolling.
El radiador corresponde a otro coche.
He says the radiator is from a different vehicle. It's from a 1951 Soviet truck. So is the carburetor. This kind of automotive transplant is common, and each of these men is their own mechanic. The cars are a tremendous source of pride, and many are considered family heirlooms. Before, my father owned it. Now I have it. When I have a son, I'll give it to him so it stays in the family. In Cuba, you'll see these automotive inheritances slowing traffic when they need a tweak. But guaranteed, they'll be moving soon because, for these drivers, that's the only way money will roll in.
Joe Munoz, Texas News 5.
Angie and Mike, we went to a state-run sugarcane farm today where the hours were long, the work was harsh, but the field hands we spoke with had no complaints.
This is morning rush hour in Santiago. As this carriage heads out to market, three men who work on a collective farm march into the sugarcane fields. Acres of it must be chopped down to be ground for cattle feed. Today, it must be done by hand under the Caribbean sun. But these men are not without company this morning. There are rats that eat the sugarcane and ants that bite your feet and legs. The men work from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Their pay? $8 a month.
When these men are out here doing this back-breaking work for hours, they say they're not thinking about themselves or the $8 a month they bring home for their families. They say they're thinking about a bigger picture.
This job has to be done, and it falls on me to do it. I don't think of myself, I think of everyone. This cane feeds cattle that provides food for the country. But not all Cubans follow this mindset that the collective will lead to a bright future. The brightest things in this time-worn apartment are paintings, done mostly in silence, for tourists. Valentina Lee Rey loves her country. She says, it's true, we have a lot of good things, like our hospitals. If I need an operation, they do it for free. If kids are sick, they treat them free. However, with a grandson and elderly mother to take care of, working a government-provided job for $10 a month won't help her.
Exactamente. Ese es mi problema.
That's my problem. If I don't eat, I can't live. How can I help Cuba? How can I even try? So she and her 23-year-old daughter, Tamara, paint, hoping vibrant colors will draw a tourist's eye, then their dollar. Last month, things weren't so good. For Tamara's birthday, all Valentina says she could afford was a small piece of chicken for her birthday dinner.
Valentina tells us, as an artist, the government makes things harder for her by charging her $200 every month in fees and taxes.